What is going on, guys? My name is Demetri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to break down for you how I make a daily journal entry as well as a daily highlight in my Notion workspace. So getting into my Notion workspace and looking at what I have here, if you can see this, I have my daily journal set up as well as my daily highlights. So this is going to be essentially what we're going to have at the end of the day when I get to showing you guys my daily planner, but this is the views that I like to look at a consistent basis on. And if we dive right into my notes database, you can also see what it'll look like, and we got everything here. So let's dive into it. If we go back to the Notion homepage, like I showcased before, let's do a slash page right here. Make a little entry journal. Writing, put a little writing, add a cover, whatever you want, do a little unsplash here, journal. Okay, so what I always like to do is specifically, I never really make full page databases. I think it's important to do inline ones because they're just, I don't want to say better, but I think they're pretty solid. So if we do notes database, we can do notes. Yeah, notes database. Then over here, what we could do is make it full width, just because I think it's preferable. Do slash table, and then make sure it's inline. And then this is how we can start building things out. So first and foremost, we're gonna wanna do is, I always like to make a template, so I can do daily journal. And that's our template here. So let's add an icon, put a little book. I think it's good to have like a little, this looks like a journal to me. I don't know about you, but I think it looks like a journal. Then right here, let's put a date. Date. So we can mark what day it ends up being. Now you could do a created time. So for example, anytime we create it, it ends up showcasing that. However, with a sort of template, you can't do that. So I'm just gonna leave that guy up to you guys. If you want to make a created time, that's a nice one to do as well. So what we can do here is I'm going to change this one to a status and change it to mood. And this is something I implemented fairly recently, but if we go into the interwebs and get an emoji, so we look up like star emoji, let's copy this bad guy and then go back to our notes database. We can do like a 1-star day, a 2-star day, 3, and then just do this up until however many you want. So that's a 5-star day. And then we have the date, the mood, and then what we're gonna do is actually add a relation, but I don't wanna get into that. So we'll save that for now. So this is the first part, but what I like to do is I actually like to have a nice little section here. So if you go H3, daily highlight, then make a little divider, put a bullet, and then type something, go down, slash H3, nightly reflection, dash divider. And then I like to do it like this. So for me right now, there's personal, then there's work, then there's YouTube. So you can customize this to whatever you want it to be. So a nice little trick I just did there is if you put one letter into these different bullets, and then you can go to the next part and then you can delete them afterwards, and then they're kind of placeholders. So this is what my daily journal will look like. So what we're gonna add here is also the daily highlight. As you can see, it's that one thing that you can do within a day that will make your day fulfilled. And for me, a big thing is making this the best it can be. So what I like to do for my daily highlight, it's a little, I don't know if it's archaic or not. I think it could be a little, be seen as a little bit archaic, but I just want to show you. So we do slash board and make it an inline one. We go daily highlights. No, for this one, you can put notes database, by the way. Drag the properties wherever you want them to be. So here, what we're going to end up doing is making a board view, as you saw earlier. That is the different days of the week. So for this one, I don't really like having the no status one out here. So we can do Monday, Tuesday, Sunday. Now, obviously you don't need to make it a board view. You can make it anything you want, and I'll give probably an extra view option, but we're gonna do here. So we're gonna go take this bad boy, and I'll show you the properties that I always end up putting in there. So I'm not gonna assign it to anybody. I'm gonna delete that, but I'll make this day. I'll add a property for a little status, which is more visual than anything. Then we'll add a progress, which is important for later. And we're gonna have it be current or finished. So the reason for this is so that you can actually take these and kind of keep the cycle going. I'll show you what I mean in a second. So now that we have these two, I'm gonna make a relation. So select relation to notes database. So I gotta make sure I pick the right one because I had my own one. So as you can see here, we have a relation or daily highlight, related highlight. Now we get these figured out. So then what I like to do is I like to go to properties and then showcase the status. And what I do is kind of, I don't know if it may seem different to others, but what I like to do here is set a filter. And the filter is the progress is current. So see that disappeared. So let me undo that really quick. So what I'm gonna do is set this guy to current. And you can notice something. When I set this filter of progress is current, what I can do here is, for example, since let's make this Tuesday. So today is Tuesday when I'm recording this. So like I had for myself, record four videos. Now, throughout the week, we can plan and have our daily highlights in front of us, and well, we can check this off, and it's nice to see that we accomplished it. In order to get the cycle repeated throughout the week, so Wednesday, I'm just gonna give examples for you guys, Thursday. Then what we can do here is we can take these and yeah, sure, they check off, but they don't disappear. But then, when you do this, you can highlight them all, change the progress to finished. Let me do that again for you guys. So if you highlight any of them, right-click it, edit property, progress, finished, then they disappear, and then you can add the new week on. And you know when they were done by connecting them to things. So for example, I can go to this one, I'm gonna delete this property, and I can do record four videos. The date is today. The mood is about a 3. I'm probably at a more than that, just putting an example. Four videos at once, or in one day. Then I can put blurbs about everything else. And then I just put the same daily highlight name. So yeah, I'm checking it off when it's done. But then I can right click at the end of the week and change this to finished, or I can do it in here. And that's kind of how I do my daily highlights, and I refresh them all the time. So another view that you can have that I want to show you guys, and I'm just going to leave this how it is with the template, is if we add a table view, or actually a list view, I think probably looks better. If we add a list view, just call it daily journal. All notes is the other one's name. We add daily journal. We do a little filter setting here. Filter where date is today. So as you can see, anytime you're, and if you want to show the properties of the date, you can. So then if you hit this here, this new one will automatically have that date that you're currently on. Then you can quickly do this, and then it's a nice little daily journal entry. If you want to separate things a little bit more, you can put a block in between these two. So the all notes. So that's how I have my daily highlight and my notes database. And then I paste the Notion relations or the linked databases into stuff like this, which is where my daily highlight or my daily planner is. And then you can see that's kind of how we have everything going on here. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I appreciate every single one of you. And with that being said, I will see you guys in the next one.